Let's then turn to our top focus today, Narendra Modi's war memorial politics. Were the images that dominated television screens this evening as Prime Minister Narendra Modi today inaugurated India's first national war memorial in the national capital. The event, however, took distinct political overtones as the Prime Minister used the occasion to tear into the Congress and the Gandhi family in particular, accusing them of making money in defense deals and allegedly ignoring the welfare of soldiers. The Congress says the Prime Minister must apologize for using the occasion for political allegations. Here is tonight's top story.
A fitting tribute to India's brave hearts. A memorial that honors their sacrifice, inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. But politics over the memorial took the sheen out of the event that was to be a homage to India's martyrs. Moments before the inauguration, Prime Minister Modi launched a scathing attack on the Congress, claiming the family came first for them, not India.
आखिर वो कौन सी वजह थी जिसकी वजह से किसी का ध्यान शहीदों के लिए स्मारक पर नहीं गया? भाई और बहनों, इंडिया फर्स्ट या फैमिली फर्स्ट? इंडिया फर्स्ट और फैमिली फर्स्ट का जो अंतर है वही इसका जवाब है। साथियों, बोफोर्स से लेकर हेलीकॉप्टर तक सारी जांच का एक ही परिवार तक पहुंचना बहुत कुछ कह जाता है।
Just hours earlier, Congress MP Kapil Sibal had trained guns at the Prime Minister, asking how the memorial will save the lives of jawans.
That's great. Memorials are wonderful, but these memorials have to be looked at with actions on the ground. That what have we done for those jawans who lost their lives? While we stand with our jawans. And our hearts go out to those families who lost their brave family members.
The Congress further added that the memorial is being used for publicity ahead of polls. The BJP in turn accused the Congress of playing politics over martyrs.
मैं देख रहा हूँ कि हर चीज़ को आज एक publicity का जरिया बनाया जा रहा है। ये भी एक जो नेशनलिज्म की जो आज पूरा एक माहौल तैयार करने की बात हो रही है, ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे इससे पहले देश के अंदर नेशनलिज्म था ही नहीं।
I salute Prime Minister for not only having this thought but also implementing it in a very very short time frame to dedicate it to the nation.
War of words has erupted between the BJP and the Congress on the issue of war memorial, with Congress coming out and slamming Modi regime, saying that it is indulging only in tokenism, whereas on ground is not doing much for the betterment of the armed as well as the paramilitary personals. With Rajanesh, Ashwini, Helen, Supriya Bhardwaj for India Today in Delhi.
Let's raise some big questions tonight. Has this war memorial actually been politicized? Have previous governments really done enough for our soldiers? Is politicizing a war memorial a disservice to martyrs? Just some of the questions that we will raise tonight. I'm joined by Lieutenant General B.S. Jaiswal, former commander of the Northern Command, Major General Satbir Singh, defense expert Brigadier Chitranjan Sawant is also joining me. I appreciate all of you joining us. I want to keep the politicians away because we've had enough of their politics over the years. I want to ask you gentlemen today, your thoughts when you see this war memorial today. Why don't you start, General Sawant, you give us your sense. How do you see, Chitranjan Sawantji, how do you see what has happened today at India Gate? Do you believe this is a moment we should be celebrating, or did the Prime Minister strike the wrong chord by using it to attack the Gandhi family?
Well, to start with, Rajdeep Sardesai, I say greetings to you on this great day when we have our own war memorial, the first one. We have been trying to have one for a long time, but well, after so many years, we got one. And well, the nation deserves it. So I'm very happy indeed that we have got it. As far as politics is concerned, as I said in another discussion on another channel, that we can leave the bickerings and what we say in Hindi, tutu meme, aside for the day, and be united as a nation to pay homage to the martyrs of various wars since 1947. Well, I have had the privilege of paying visits to various war memorials, and even smaller towns now have. That means the common man feels inspired. And in Noida, where I live, we have a war memorial. And the chief of the army staff, mm-hmm. chief of the naval staff, chief of the air staff, they come turn by turn once a year. Moral of the story, Rajdeep, is that the nation is now aware that memorials do encourage us to be patriotic.
That's an interesting way to put it. Memorials do encourage us to be patriotic. But, and I come back to the question, General Satbir Singh, you and others have raised the issue of your belief one rank, one pension has not been implemented in the way that you wanted it to. You and others have raised questions of whether the treatment of Jawans is what they deserve. Is this war memorial symbolism? Or do you believe this war memorial will actually generate patriotism as is being suggested by Brigadier Sawant? Do you believe that will actually happen? Or was this today an exercise of a political event at one level where we didn't see the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, the President, but Narendra Modi was all over it?
Rajdeep, very relevant question. Well, it was a great day today when first war memorial of India has come about. This should have come about much earlier. However, this is to remember the martyrs who laid down their life for the integrity and sovereignty of the nation. Sardesai, what I can say is this was a solemn event where the Prime Minister should have talked about the valor and the sacrifices and covered certain details of the valor of our soldier right from 47 onwards till date after the independence. However, I was myself present over there and I heard the Prime Minister. I wish he should have avoided giving a political speech or an election speech. That is what is painful to me. Otherwise, National War Memorial is really welcome. It should have been there. We are all privileged to have it. As a soldier, as an Indian, I feel that we got to remember our martyrs and therefore a smarak must be there. Any country which does not respect its martyrs or soldiers is doomed to fail. But what I saw today and heard today, Prime Minister only talking about politics, about elections kind of speech, which was actually sitting on the front first seat, I could feel bad about it. That I wish Prime Minister should have talked about the valor, how we fought the 62 war, how we fought the 71 war, how we fought our 65 and thereafter the Kargil war.
Right.
How did we throw away our people and how many people died? 543 in Kargil.
No, I take your point, General Satbir Singh, you're saying that this occasion should have been to remember our martyrs rather than make it about the political battle. Do you agree with that, Lieutenant General Jaswal? That this should have been an occasion. The Prime Minister had a great opportunity to focus on what was a long-standing demand of the armed forces to have a memorial. You get the memorial, and then instead of focusing on the martyrs and our Paramveer Chakras, we end up focusing on politics.
As far as I'm concerned, there was a long-standing demand for a war memorial. It has come up. Now, everything being viewed politically, because I'm apolitical and I do not comment on it. But the fact is that this war memorial has come up as a symbol of national integrity. Mm-hmm. And it also highlights the valor of all our martyrs. I'm sentimental about it today that it has come up, because my own brother was martyred in 65 war. And to really appreciate the sentiments purely of the war memorial, I'll not go into the why part of the speech, etc., whatever it is. One has to wear the shoes of martyrs' families. They would be standing tall and proud today that their own martyrs, they have been honored. I take it that way, that it was looking through the prism of, I'll call, symbolism.
Right.
Of this war memorial, I think we should take things positively rather than going into the political part from both sides.
I take your point.
Actually,
I take your point, General. I take your point, General Jaswal. I'm also joined at this moment by General B.S. Malik. General Malik, while as is being suggested, this is an occasion to feel proud as a military man, and all of you do, the country feels, remembers its martyrs. Is it symbolism? When I raise the question, for example, look at the expenditure on defense services, preparedness of armed forces. According to a parliamentary report that was just submitted last year, it noticed that defense expenditure as a percentage of total central expenditure has gone to its lowest level since the 62 war. So there are those who are saying at one level you have the war memorial, at another level our defense preparedness, question marks being raised over that. Question marks being raised over whether our defense spending is going in the right direction. Are these questions to be raised tonight or not?
Question marks being raised over whether our defense spending is going in the right direction. Are these questions to be raised tonight?
These are not the questions for today. This is the time for us to celebrate that the country has got a war memorial. Mm-hmm. This has been a long pending demand of the armed forces. And here we are now trying to commemorate the 26,000 soldiers of the Indian Armed Forces. And this must be kept in mind, mm-hmm. that we have India Gate and we still are having our war memorial, which was erected there in a hurry. Yes, it was in a hurry because I know the gentleman who was involved behind it is no more, that is Level Jan Sinha. He was that time the adjutant general. The orders came after the 1971 that the prime minister of the day had to lay a wreath and there should be a war memorial. So hurriedly, under the arch of India Gate, a memorial was made, and just a simple rifle upside down, which is the mark of a departed soldier with a helmet on top, was erected. But let's not forget, the main thing is that India today has a national war memorial to commemorate the war deeds and the heroism of the Indians.
So it's very interesting. It's very interesting, sir. General, just a minute. It's very interesting. Therefore, General Satbir Singh, you seem to be in a minority. You were there at the event. All the other three military officers, all the other three military officers seem to be suggesting, let's just focus on the fact that finally we have a war memorial. What the Prime Minister said or how he used the occasion, as you seem to suggest, to make a political speech is not the relevant issue. Did it take away from the occasion? Do you believe the Prime Minister making a political speech there, targeting the Gandhi family, which he could target on any other day of the year, 364 days, was this the right occasion to do it? That's my only question.
Rajdeep, that is exactly which I said. I am in agreement as far as our war memorial. It is a must. Hmm. It has come about. It is great. We need to have it. But the point is, we should have remembered those martyrs who laid down their lives. Right? We expect from our political establishment, we expect from our people, the countrymen should know this is a guidelines or a motivation to the coming generation. I am not in agreement on this issue that at this time the Prime Minister should have made any kind of attacking A, B or C. Valor, valor and valor. Remember your soldiers. I am in agreement with both the generals, but I am not very happy sitting over there and listening to what our Prime Minister said. That's it.
You know, therefore you have a question mark, Brigadier Sawant. You know, this is an occasion which could have been used, as I said, or as is being said by General Singh, to remember the valor of our martyrs, to perhaps tell this generation the great history of our military forces. It became about Congress versus BJP.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, as the two generals said, and partly John Sarbir also, that today is not the day when we go into bickerings and when we celebrate. There are certain occasions when we should all celebrate. Like you have a color presentation in a regiment, that day you don't go into nitty-gritties and, well, you just celebrate. You have a drink, probably one too many, and well, you say cheers, cheers to the flag, cheers to the colors, and you imbibe the trust and also, well, patriotism. Mm-hmm. So today is the day, I believe, that it should be that you have a leader and, well, you have a faith, you have a mission. And right now, in the present circumstances, the mission is beat the enemy, whosoever the enemy may be.
Right.
And therefore, we stand united. And, well, like the Marathas, they rose under Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, and they beat the enemy. At that time, there was no bickering at all. Today is the right day to remain united under, well,
If we had to remain united today, then today was an occasion perhaps to have all our political parties there. Today was an occasion perhaps to have the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, the President there, along with the Prime Minister. This could have been an occasion for national unity, General Jaswal, because we've seen and we are going to see much more of this political bickering on the election campaign. Was today the day, I come back to it, to do all this? Today was a day to remember our martyrs and have all the political leaders there, in a sense, across party lines, come to the war memorial to pay tribute to them unitedly. That's my limited point. Has this in some way taken away? This became about an event management around the Prime Minister, instead of an occasion, some would say, to celebrate. A Congress party is claiming this became event management. What is your response to what the Congress party claims?
Well, Rajdeep, as
first
far
day,
as
I cannot legislate as to why. Is,
yeah, just a minute.
The various parties did not come in.
Yes. Go ahead, General Jaswal.
Can. I cannot legislate the actions of various political parties. If they are nationalists, they should have come over there.
So you're saying
if they are nationalists, they should have come over there. I'm not sure of the president as to why he could not come. That because I'm not aware of it. But let me tell you, there's a larger issue. This is a sanctum sanctorum which has been given to the whole nation. Let's look at that. There may be other things, because I go deaf when these political squabblings go on.
Yes.
I go deaf on that. I look at the larger issue. And to date, I'm standing at this moment also at the larger issue. The symbol of national integrity has been gifted to the armed forces and to the nation. We must cherish this, and we should put rest of the things aside. there is enough ammunition available to all political parties to keep bickering against or, you know, picking on anyone. I go deaf on that. I have a one aim. I'm proud that today we have a symbol which is of national integrity. I would not like to legislate the actions of any other political party.
General Malik, do you believe that we should not only now have a, we have a war, national war memorial now, but we should have a, perhaps a war museum? This country needs this generation to remember the sacrifice in the past. We need to know about General Sir, we need to know about Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw. We need to know about Air Chief Marshal Arjun Singh. We need to know about the great generals and the great Air Force chiefs that this country has had.
Yes, Rajdeep, you are quite right. Unfortunately, there are people on the 10th of November this year, last year, that is on 2018, a report appeared in one of the newspaper that war memorial may claim India Gates openness may be the casualty. I mean, I was surprised. I got the article in front of me. I was surprised. You can have a look at it. And I was surprised when this appeared. I mean, there are people who are looking at the aesthetics and things and trying to deny the nation and the armed forces a war memorial. And that is the reason this war memorial, apparently, as I came to know, was to be inaugurated on 26th of January this year. It couldn't be inaugurated because of the controversy. It's very, very unfortunate. Let's not forget, I was in the Indian High Commission in London,
right,
and there we have a Commonwealth War Grave Commission. India Gate is erected by the Commonwealth War Grave Commission, and the land under the India Gate has been given out in perpetuity by the Government of India to the Commonwealth War Grave Commission. So technically, the war memorial that we claim to be ours was not there. It belonged to the land which is of the Commonwealth War Grave Commission. Today, we have our own Indian Army War Memorial. This is something to be proud of. Let's not get involved in other things.
Yes, in
the same article, Rajdeep, there was a talk of the war museum. Again, there was a bickering. No one wanted to claim and no one wanted to tell the actual truth about the whole thing. Because there are people, there are vested interests, but let us put them aside.
I take your point. Can I get one final word from General Satbir Singh? Because you have been the face of the agitation on Orop. Is that agitation and all your concerns now set aside today? Do you believe that Prime Minister Modi has done something which has not been done by previous governments and therefore deserves today his moment in the sun?
Well, we have already thanked our Prime Minister to have built this war memorial, which was dearly required, for which I am with everyone as a soldier and as Indian. I was only commenting on what was said today. If it was Solomon, it should have been Solomon. That's it. And it should have been only bravery. All my officers are talking about, welcome. They have their own view. But I, as a soldier, feel that way. One rank, one pension, he did mention also. Well, that has not been given fully. That will be very straightforward to you. That, well, they have done something, but they have not given what the Prime Minister said today. I don't want to comment today, as others said. There will be another day. I have requested for a meeting with Prime Minister. Let him give me 15 minutes. I'll have the things mentioned over there. But today is a solemn day to have our own martyrs memorial. I am with all the other soldiers. But what was said today, I wish it could have been only valor and valor of the soldiers.
Thank you all very much for joining me. Four voices, no politicians, each of you today. Today is a day to celebrate the fact that we have a national war memorial. But unfortunately, it's also a day where maybe politics at one level took over. Thank you all very much for joining me, though. My take. The national war memorial in the heart of the country's capital has been a long-standing demand of the armed forces. In the many wars this country has fought since 1947, there is a need to remind today's India about the sacrifices made by our armed forces over the years. That Prime Minister Modi's government took the initiative where his predecessors have failed deserves to be applauded. And yet today's ceremony left a distinct sense of being a party political event rather than being what it should have always been, a solemn occasion to remember our soldiers. Why, for example, was the president, who's the supreme commander of the armed forces, not invited to the ceremonies? Why was no opposition leader there? Let's be clear. The armed forces belong to the nation and not to an individual or a party. Today was an occasion for a collective spirit of nationhood to be celebrated, not to target political rivals. In that sense, Mr. Modi perhaps missed an opportunity to rise above the din of electoral politics. We need to realize that elections and political leaders will come and go. A war memorial is a permanent structure that must outlive all parties and interests. We can only hope that no one, be it in the government or the opposition, plays politics with our martyrs. Let's put India first by putting our soldiers and their dignity first.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.